For me, it was really interesting because I never thought I could actually do something like this. I always figured it was extremely complicated and that only like the really advanced scientists could do it.
The Morpholution class is teaching students to use software called Morphobank that scientists use doing real projects. So we're simulating a small scale project of mammals and the mammal tree of life.
Students are learning about the traits that scientists use to collect data and make inferences about how species are related to one another. They're really starting from scratch, and what's so great about this program is that they're really in the role of scientists.
Morphobank is a really good way of organizing information, and because part of what we do with Morphobank is work collaboratively with other scientists and use imagery to communicate the pieces of anatomy or the observations that we see about different animals. It's a really good way to get students thinking about how you communicate science. And by doing it in an actual matrix format as we do in Morphobank, this is actually the format that we take to analyze, to build evolutionary trees.
We looked over several species, including the Sumatransis rhinoceros, and we looked at the different character traits of each of the animals.
I really liked the experience because I actually got to learn a lot about, like, not only the actual like species that we studied, but like also the whole process that goes into like putting all this data in.
As with a lot of our youth programs here at the museum, the students are really utilizing the unique resources of the museum. And those unique resources are the halls, they're the scientific collections that we use, and in this program in particular, they're using a lot of the digital media for their learning.
It was cool to see that we compiled something and we could actually do it versus having to take the data that was already given to us and basically say, this is the answer.